Well, here we are. We are finally going to do something about this shop. I've been putting it off for the longest, but today we're at least going to start doing something. Coming up in this video. So guys, as you see, the shed is a mess, quite honestly. And you see, I'm actually standing on a ramp. And I made the ramp. Doesn't look horrible. Probably not the greatest one, but you know what? It should do the job. Because I got tired of trying to get up so high here, and I had junk all cluttered here. I couldn't even get inside. I wanted to maximize the amount of trash and debris that I could put in the back of the storage unit as well. So we got that going for us. But anyway, let's show you what we got going on. So walking on inside here, going up this ramp, here we have it. Not the brightest light still. I have not addressed those yet, but hopefully soon. We still have all the parts for when we painted the BMW. We've got everything just literally littered and thrown about here. And honestly, I should feel ashamed of myself because it doesn't look good in here, quite honestly. It really doesn't. But we're gonna try and make something happen. And since this is only a 10 by 16, we have to make the most use of our space. I had a couple plans that I drew up that I wanted to do, but now I'm not too quite sure about it. So we're gonna go through a period of trial and error and see what we can come up with. So I feel like I got something done, and the lighting is here in here is horrible. But anyway, we're gonna keep on going. So the next thing to do is to see how high or low I want everything. I'm kind of wondering if I want the bench higher up. I think I do want that for the main purpose of being able to store more stuff underneath. So don't know how to go, but that's at least what I'm thinking. All right, so we just got some measuring done inside of the shed, and accounting for the inch and a half thick, the 2x4s are, I've got some 21 inch cuts that I need to make. I don't know what box this is, but we're using it to draw out what we want. Now, originally I was thinking about doing an actual rolling kind of workbench, but I said, you know what, this time I still want one of those, but for right now, I want to build it high enough off and make it a floating workbench, so that way I can store stuff under it and I can have more space. And actually, I want it to a nice height. I don't want it too low where I'm constantly bending over, but I kind of want it at like a standing height, if that makes sense, which will kind of render my little rolling stool somewhat useless, but I think I'm gonna give it a try and I'm gonna see how I like it. I mean, if not, we can always lower it down to a lower dimension. So I'm gonna do a little bit more measuring and then we're gonna move on from there. So this is what we got so far right here. And actually it kind of brightens up the longer these lights are on, because it actually looks pretty bright in here. But anyway, so I was originally planning on going around this high, just going even higher, if I can try and let you guys get to see, like right under that windowsill. But this height works as well. And I'm not just saying that because the highest that my horses goes is that high, but it actually feels pretty good. Like my personal measurement, my gut to table is pretty good. Everything is right here.
wouldn't have to bend down much. And I don't want everything too high because then I'll be losing space underneath here. So I think this may be a height that I'm gonna go with. Of course, it's a little uneven and crooked for right now, but I'll fix that as well. So what I'm gonna do is kind of position it along the wall, see how I want it, because this is gonna be storage back here. And from there, we'll keep going. Guys, we got one side done. Not sure if I have enough screws to make a second side that's gonna go over here, but I must say overall it looks really good. Now off camera I am going to clean this up, but this is the first step. The first step to actually having a workbench that I can use, and I'm loving it so far. I may add another bracing down here, I'm not sure. I want as much space as I can, so now I can throw stuff like this compressor under there and get it out the way. Maybe stack some of these totes as well under here as well, just to get them out of the way. But man, I am happy and I'm fully confident that I can lay my whole fat body across there and I know I won't fall or die or anything like that. So that's gonna be it for this video. Out this morning and I wanted to get a little bit more done. I know it was going to rain today, and so I wanted to get a lot of my cuts done, even though I ended up having to cut inside a little bit. But I already made the frame for the next floating workbench, but then I ran into a problem that I could actually use you guys' opinion on. I'm trying to set this thing up on how I think it's going to be proficient, but I've got some thoughts in my head, so I'm gonna flip the camera and I'm gonna show you guys exactly what I'm thinking. So the first thing is, when you come in, first off, it's going to be right there. And I guess I could like cut that so that way I don't jab myself every time I come in the door, which I doubt I'll do it. But of course, when I'm not thinking of it, that's going to happen. But after that, I see, you guys see that one bench is further back than the other bench. Now, my mindset was this. This side right here would have my blue roll cart. The big one right there. So that way, when I'm working on the car or something right here, I don't have to go all the way to the back of the shed to actually get whatever tool I need. I can be real convenient and get my stuff right here. So then we move on to this side here. This side was going to be designated for a toolbox that I'm going to eventually purchase, because I can't work out of the roll cart alone. I've got way more tools than that. So one of the 44-inch toolboxes, maybe from Harbor Freight or something. I haven't decided. Seems like Harbor Freight toolboxes also have went up to like $500, which I swore I thought it was like $379 or something like that. I can't remember. But either way, toolbox goes right here. Then right here would be, at least for a section of the wall, would be shelves to store everything that I have. Then right here would also be a compressor. So this little corner part right here where you see the tripod and that tote would be where a bigger compressor would go, because I can't keep working with the old puny boy. That's what I was thinking. But then I'm saying to myself, okay, well, what about my welder? I'm going to buy another welder soon as well, have a second welder that does TIG, hopefully eventually. And that's the next problem that I'm running into. How would I set this up so that way I can have the most space? Should I not have a workbench at all over here? Should I turn this into just shelves? I'm not sure. So I'm not going to move any further from here. So guys, if you have any opinion or observation or anything that would help me organize this workshop, I am all for it. But overall, guys, I am pretty happy with how everything honestly turned out, to be honest with you. I took my time. I didn't rush. I used my square so everything was properly square. I wasn't just eyeballing it. On top of that, I pre-drilled everything, as you guys saw. I tried to make it where it was nice and smooth across. There was no highs and low spots and everything. So I feel really good about it. But those were the questions that I had. How can I properly set this up so I can get the most usage out of it? And who knows, maybe I can just get a welding cart that I can build one that's short enough that can go up under there. Maybe I'll do that. I'm not sure if that's an option or not, but we'll see. I'll be reading all of you guys' comments, so please, comment section below if you have any observations or opinions. But anyway, guys, we are going to end this video here. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Let me know what you think. Peace out.